Well, a Memorial Day weekend tradition for many families involves a trip to the cemetery. Jet 24's Kristen Nielsen met with families paying tribute to loved ones who've served.
It's a beautiful day in Erie, and at local cemeteries this Memorial Day weekend, you'll find people scattered throughout. They're here to remember the sacrifices of family members who joined the military.
It's nice to see you. Everybody has been busy planting flowers, and it's great to see the flags and remember our fallen and the ones that have served.
My dad is a World War II veteran, served his country well.
For Shirley Barnes, the memories of her father's war stories remain fresh in her mind.
He was an infantryman in those holes where they shoot the guns. He'd often talk about how he would just sleep in those holes and just pray to God that he'd get out.
And he did, returning home to serve in another capacity. He and his wife founded the Friendship Missionary Baptist Church in Erie and Dunkirk, New York. But during his service, he faced battles on and off the front lines.
He was doing it during a time when it wasn't real popular for black men to be in the service. So not only did he have to look out for his fellow man from Mississippi, he had to look out for the German warfare as well.
For service members who passed away, it's up to their family members to keep their legacy alive.
He was 18 when he was killed, and he just got over to, I believe it was Okinawa, and he had just gotten there. Only served about a month after boot camp.
Susan Wolbert never got to meet her uncle, but she honors his sacrifice. Every year, she plants flowers around his tombstone for Memorial Day. Despite stories like this, many families have a long tradition of service to our country.
We all would not be standing here today if it wasn't for our forefathers.
In Erie, Kristen Nielsen, Jet 24 Action News.
Great story.